Good morning. Welcome back with me, Adrian, with some Indonesian elementary students in daily Bible reading. As usual, every morning we will read the New English Translation Bible from the Old Testament in the book of Genesis. Last time we read about the birth of Ishmael, the son of Hagar, to Abraham. Ishmael was not the son God promised to Abraham. So today we shall continue the Bible reading from Genesis chapter 16, verse 10. But before that, let's pray. Good morning, Father. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Holy Spirit. Thank you so much for today, for your love, mercy, and grace. Thank you for your protection during the day. And thank you for giving us a chance again to read your Bible today. So God, please open our hearts, our minds, our ears, and our eyes so we are able to know the truth from the Bible that we are going to read. Speak to us, Lord, for we are ready to listen to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. So, are you ready to read the Bible? Let's get started.
I will greatly multiply your descendants, the Lord's angels added, so that they will be too numerous to count. Then the Lord's angels said to her, "You are now pregnant and are about to give birth to a son. You are to name him Ishmael, for the Lord has heard your painful."
Hello, today I want to read Bible from Genesis chapter 16, verse 12 to 13. "He will be a wild donkey of a man. He will be hostile to everyone, and everyone will be hostile to him. He will live away from his brothers." So Hagar named the Lord who spoke to her, "You are the God who sees me." For she said, "Here I have seen one who sees me." Amen.
From Genesis chapter 16, verse 14. "That is why the well was called Nearby Rock. It is located between Hades and Abyss." So Hagar gave birth to Abram's son, whom Abram named Ishmael. Now Abram was 60 years old when Hagar gave birth to Ishmael.
Hello, today I want to read the Bible from Genesis chapter 17, verse 1 to 2. "The sign of the covenant. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, 'I am the sovereign God. Walk before me and be blameless. Then I will confirm my covenant between me and you, and I will give you a multitude of descendants.'" Amen.
Today I want to read Bible from Genesis chapter 17, verse 3-6. "Abram bowed down with his face to the ground, and God said to him, 'As for me, this is my covenant with you. You will be the father of a multitude of nations. No longer will your name be Abram. Instead, your name will be Abraham, because I will make you the father of a multitude of nations. I will make you extremely fruitful. I will make nations of you, and kings will descend from you.
Hello everyone. Today I want to read Bible from Genesis chapter 17, verse 7 to 8. I will confirm my covenant as a perpetual covenant between me and you. It will extend to your descendants. After you throw out their generation, I will be your God, and the God of your descendants after you. I will give the whole land of Canaan, the land where you are now residing, to you and your descendants after you as a permanent possession. I will be their God.
From Genesis chapter 17, verse 9 to 11. Then God said to Abraham, "As for you, you must keep the covenantal requirement I am imposing on you and your descendants after you choke out their generation. This is my requirement, that you and your descendants after you must keep every male among you must be circumcised. You must circumcise the flesh of your foreskin. This will be a reminder of the covenant between me and you."
Hello, today I want to read Bible from Genesis chapter 17, verse 12 to 14. Through your generation, every male among you who is 8 days old must be circumcised, whether born in your house or bought with money from any foreigner who is not one of your descendants. They must indeed be circumcised, whether born in your house or bought with money. The sins of my covenant will be visible in your flesh as a permanent remnant. Any uncircumcised male who has not been circumcised in the flesh of his foreskin will be cut off from his people. He has failed to carry out my requirements.
Hello, today I want to read Bible from Genesis chapter 17, verse 15 to 17. Then God said to Abraham, "As for your wife, you must no longer call her Sarah. Sarah will be her name. I will bless her and will give you a son through her. I will bless her and she will become a mother of nations. Kings of countries will come from her." Then Abraham bowed down with his face to the ground and laughed as he said to himself, "Can a son be born to a man who is 100 years old? Can Sarah bear a child at the age of 90?
Hi, today I'm reading Bible from Genesis chapter 17, verses 18 to 20. Abraham said to God, "Oh, that Ishmael might live before you." God said, "No, Sarah, your wife, is going to bear you a son, and you will name him Isaac. I will confirm my covenant with him as a perpetual covenant for his descendants after him. As for Ishmael, I have heard you. I will indeed bless him, make him fruitful and give him a multitude of descendants. He will become the father of 12 princes. I will make him into a great nation.
We just read the covenant God made with Abraham along with his descendants. God promised to be God for Abraham and for his descendants, and also to give the promised land for Abraham and also for his descendants. And circumcision was the covenantal requirement for Abraham and for his descendants. So that's it for today. We shall continue our Bible reading next time. Enjoy your victorious day. Jesus bless you, and bye-bye.